Good morning, everybody. Michael the Maven, and today I'm going to be answering some questions about filters, specifically the main strengths and differences between a square drop-in filter versus a circular threaded filter. As many of you know, I have created my own line of ND filters. We have 6 and 10 stop filters. And in one of my videos, I talked about why this is probably more affordable and easier to get into, and somebody took offense with it. What I said in the video was you can buy adapter rings that allow you to use the filters on literally any lens. And I was talking mainly about, you know, landscape photography. The truth of the matter is, absolutely, you can buy an 82 millimeter size filter, one of the larger filters, and use step down rings. So it'll adapt from that 82 millimeters to a 77 millimeter or a 72 millimeter and so on and so forth. You would just need to have that specific ring. So one of the questions that I got, first of all, is when a manufacturer has it in a square filter as well as a circular filter, is the performance of the glass the same? The short answer on this is it should be, but I cannot speak for the quality control of these other companies, but if they have a specific model and a specific ND density, they should perform similarly, and it would just depend on what your preference is for these, you know, square versus circular. So let's talk about some of the strengths and weaknesses and even the types of photography that different shooters would prefer them in. I use the square drop-in filters primarily because I am a landscape shooter, and its greatest strength is that it allows for up to 3 filters on this one holder. So I can drop in a polarizer, I can drop in an ND filter, I can drop in a grad filter and shoot with all 3 the same time. If I'm doing a sunset and the lighting conditions are changing, I can raise the grad filter up and down within a second. So it allows for very fast changes of the filters. It allows for stacking. For pure beginners, there is a really affordable kit. It's $28. It comes with all the adapter rings, the filter holder, the ND filters, and some grad filters in the kit. And it allows beginners to get started without having to invest a ton of money for all these other, you know, expensive rings and adapters. There are different sizes of square filters. This is a P, which is an 84 by 84, a 100 millimeter size Z. So what I'm saying is, for the cost, it's a lot easier to get started with one of those cheapy kits. They can figure out if they want to get serious about it. And when they're ready to upgrade, all they need to do is buy, you know, the high-end filter, and they can drop it in and use those adapter rings moving forward. Now, there are some serious limitations to this kind of a setup. I think the biggest is the problem with light leaks. This happens when light reflects and gets between the filter and the lens itself. You can see this as kind of like a ring. You see the reflection of the lens. The way to get around that is to use a gasket that creates a seal between the filter and the holder, and that's going to limit it most of the time. Another problem is that on very wide angle lenses, talking about, you know, less than 20 millimeters, is you can start to see vignetting in the corners. It's very common. And so for landscape photography, that could be a problem. And another problem is these are kind of loose fitting. You can just grab them and pull them in and out. So if you're changing your camera position a lot, if you're getting up and you're moving around or you're hiking, you know, even around a studio moving around a lot, probably not ideal. You're gonna want something a little bit more fixed to the lens. But for landscape shooting, I've seen these a lot on film productions where they're using drop-in filters because of the speed in terms of being able to change. That's why I recommended it. However, let's talk about some of the strengths and weaknesses of the circular filter. Circular filters are amazing because when you thread them directly into the lens, you do not have the light leak problems, you do not have the vignetting problems, and it's a better protector of the glass. You know, if you're handling it by the metal ring, it doesn't get as dirty. You know, if you drop it, there's hopefully a chance it'll survive easier. And the best part about these is that you can move them around. They're not gonna fall off. On the negative side, you can't stack multiple filters without threading through the lens, and that takes a significant amount of time. And it really comes down to what type of shooting you're doing and how fast you wanna be about it. But in any event, I hope that answers your questions about the differences, the strengths and weaknesses between a circular filter and a square filter, and I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions or comments. If you're looking for a great square ND filter, check out my brand new Maven filters. I'll also have those links in the description. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.